Hey, Sergio here with Arthur and Hansen, and for this week's tailgate safety topic, we'll be covering atmospheric testing of confined spaces. If you have any confined spaces in your workplace, you should be aware that there's a potential for atmospheric hazards like toxic gases or a lack of oxygen. If you're not sure what a confined space is or how to identify one, make sure to check this video out. Designated employees who test the atmosphere should make sure that they understand what they're testing for and how to perform that test. Many confined spaces must be entered by workers to perform work inside that space. That work can range anywhere from maintenance and repairs to simply just cleaning the space out. No matter the task, employees are at risk when they enter the space, especially when there's a potential for a hazardous atmosphere inside that space. The only way to know for sure is to verify the conditions. Atmospheric testing simply evaluates the hazards in the confined space and verifies that the conditions are acceptable for entry. When atmospheric testing should be conducted, certain procedures must be followed. Atmospheric testing begins with an evaluation to understand how the space will be managed. Think of it as a risk assessment to 1, determine what hazards are or may become present in the space atmosphere, and 2, identify what steps must be followed and what conditions must be met to ensure that atmospheric conditions are safe for a worker to enter that space. For example, a sewer system's atmospheric hazards could have H2S or low oxygen levels. And a tank that is used to have fuel in it may also have a flammable atmosphere with a potential for fire or explosion. The test results and decisions about what steps must be followed before entry must be evaluated or reviewed by a qualified professional. These results and steps become a crucial part of the permit required confined space entry procedures. Great, you have now concluded your evaluation test and have developed the necessary steps to be followed for safe entry. So testing is done now, right? Well, no. We will need to protect the worker when they enter the space. A verification test must be conducted to ensure that conditions at the time of entry are safe as well. Simply put, verification testing is conducted to make sure that the atmospheric hazards that may be present are below the levels necessary for safe entry, and that they meet the conditions specified on the permit. For example, low oxygen levels may prompt you to improve ventilation of the space before sending in workers. When performing a test, the correct sequence is to test for oxygen first, then combustible gases, and then for toxic gases or vapors, in that order. Most monitors test for these simultaneously. Test results must be recorded on the permit, confirming that the levels identified are safe for entry. For each test required on the permit, you must allow enough time for the air to be drawn into the equipment and for the sensor to react. So take your time and do it right. Make sure to refer to the testing equipment manufacturer's recommendation for the minimum response time, as it may change when attaching tubing or a probe extension. When testing the different types of confined spaces, always keep in mind that the space may have layered atmospheres because some gases may be lighter or heavier than others. Conditions at the point of entry must also be the same as the space where the work is being performed. Testing must be done in the area surrounding the worker, which is 4 feet in the direction of travel and to each side. Finally, routinely test the space and make sure that the atmospheric conditions continue to be safe for entry. This includes testing before someone re-enters, even though testing was conducted earlier that day. Conditions often change, sometimes just by the type of work that's being done. For example, deaths have occurred from vehicle exhaust fumes entering the space through ventilation fans. When testing shows that there are atmospheric hazards present, controls must be implemented in order to eliminate the hazard and/or protect the worker when eliminating the hazard is not feasible. To learn more about the controls you may use to control these hazards, be sure to keep an eye out for next week's tailgate safety topic. If you need any help with your confined space program, feel free to contact us using the information provided below. And make sure to follow us on all platforms for more safety tips and tricks. And until next time, thank you.